My name is Emily Veltkamp. I'm a freshman here at the University of Kentucky. I'm an English major with an emphasis in creative writing, and I'm planning on going into the MIC program. From the past few years now, I've identified as queer rather than bisexual, simply because I feel very prevalent stigmas that are against bisexuality in our culture. So keeping that away from my personal life as much as possible is a priority when it comes to my identity.
What does it feel like when someone tells you that what you are isn't real? That your identity doesn't exist? I have felt this. It's not only hurtful, it's confusing.
I think oftentimes the stereotype against people that identify as bisexual is that they're greedy or that they can't choose or they're confused. People say, oh, why can't you choose just men or just women? And I don't think there's really any truth in that. I think it's more just a lack of understanding. And I think erasure is even more significant than discrimination or stereotypes. It's very common in pop culture in Hollywood for actors or actresses that come out and say, I identify as bisexual, to just have their sexuality determined by whoever their current partner is. There have been times where people have taken my sexuality or my experiences with women in particular as a joke or something to be sexualized rather than part of my identity. So it's definitely a problem, and I think I'm not the only one who that occurs with. Bisexuality is way more common than people think it is, and there's no harm in saying I like more than one gender. And even if that identity of being bisexual or being queer, being pansexual, being whatever term that you want to apply to it, is erased from the media, from daily discourse and discussion, that doesn't mean that those people aren't out there, that they aren't, in happy romantic and sexual relationships. It's a normal thing. It's just as normal as any other identity within the LGBTQ spectrum.